Marcus Whitman Visual and Performing Arts production of The Wizard of Oz. Before we begin, a few announcements. In case of emergency, use the exits at the rear of the auditorium and proceed to the right and out the doors to the parking lot. No flash photography is allowed, and due to copyright restrictions, no video recording is permitted. At this time, please take a moment to completely turn off and power down your cell phones and other electronic devices. Even in silent mode, their electronic emissions can interfere with our wireless sound system. And now, the Marcus Whitman Visual and Performing Arts presents The Wizard of Oz.
Afraid of. Just gotta stand up to her, that's all. With a little courage, a little grit. I'm not afraid of her.
That's what I wanted to hear. Walk with your head up, your chest out, and the next time she squawks, you stroll right on up to her and spit in her eye. That's what I'd do.
Would you really?
Sure I would. Through this life, you gotta walk tall, shoot straight, and then you got no reason to be scared of nothing and nobody.
Oh,
what are you trying to do, kill a guy?
Oh, how can you be so cruel?
It was just a rib, Dorothy.
Oh, you really scared him. Can't you see how white he is?
Scared? Who is scared?
Oh, you're so scared. You jackrabbit, you'll be the next county by now.
What's all this jabberwopping when there's work to be done? 903 shiftless farmhands that'll be out of a job before they know it.
Well, we'll just have a little fun, Mrs. Gale.
Well, a farm's no place for fun. You want fun? Go join the circus.
I just do that. Be a strong man.
Well, don't start posing for it now. Here, can't work on an empty stomach. Have some cookies.
Oh, gosh, Miss Gale.
Just
wait. Well,
don't have to sit down and eat them. You, get that wagon hitched up and see. Feed those hogs before they worry themselves into an amion.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, Auntie, I really don't know this goat's going to do a total. Dorothy, dear, stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fret over nothing. Well, just help us out today and find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble. Some place where there isn't any trouble. I wonder if there is such a place, Toto. There must be. Not a place you can get to by boat or train. It's far, far away. Beyond the moon. Beyond the rain. When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble.
Thank you.
my life, Miss Gulch. And
I need to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
What's she done? I'm all but lame from the bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
Good afternoon, Miss Gulch. I just made a fresh batch of cookies, if you don't mind to sit a while.
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken by the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
Well, if you don't eat, you'll waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, can you bring Toto here a minute? Well, I'm sure if the girl's upset you in any way, she'd be more than happy to apologize as best she can.
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Miss Gulch here seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
Oh, that's not true.
I'm an act of public service, young woman. I'm taking him to the sheriff to see that he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Oh, Toto, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Henny Ann, we won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we, Ann?
Oh, Annie, yeah, really? He didn't mean to. Well, Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I know that often punished, you can send me to bed without supper.
Oh, you hear how sorry the child is. Surely she promises to give your place a wide berth.
If you have to hand over that dog now, I'll bring a damage suit that'll take your whole farm. There's laws protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Well, how did be she keeps him tied up? He's really a gentle dog. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's my order allowing me to take the dog, unless you want to go against the law.
Well...
What's it say, Henry?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
Oh, no, please, no.
Well, we can't go against the law, Dorothy.
Not your same reason.
Oh, no, 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 I won't let you take him. You go away, or I'll fight you myself.
Dorothy!
Oh, you wicked old witch. Oh, Uncle Henry, Henny Ann, don't let her take him, please.
Stop her!
There's no use running, Dorothy.
Henry, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Let me have him, Dorothy.
Oh, please.
Put him in the basket, Henry.
Oh, no, that's all I might.
Oh, Toto!
Oh, well, Myra Gulch, just because you own half the town doesn't mean you have the right to run the rest of us. Oh, for 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I thought of you, and, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it!
Well, I can. So if you don't want to hear it, you can pelt your carcass off of my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just remember, I have friends in high places.
Well, you can go climb on your broomstick and go fist them. You got that conversation up yet?
We really don't, Mr. Gale.
Really done ain't good enough. You get to right now. Sky's getting darker every minute, darn it.
Oh, come inside, honey.
No, I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let Toto go.
Oh, we had an order from the sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect me to do? Wiggle on and make it disappear.
Well, you could have at least tried. And you stood there like you were stuffed or something.
I couldn't think of anything. Oh, I'm sorry.
One mean old woman and you were scared of her.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you, worst of all, you stopped Toto from getting away. I just hate you.
Don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel like my heart's all torn out.
Oh, I don't care. I never want to see any of you again, ever. Toto was the only friend I had in this world. I got no one to talk to, no one to play with. I'll never see him again as long as I live. Toto! Oh, Toto, you came back! Oh, you got away from that horrible woman, you wonderful dog! Oh, but she'll be back for you any minute. We've got to get away. We've got to run away. We need food for me and a bone for you. Oh, and then we've got to get far, far away from here. And we're never, ever coming back.
Here, doggy, doggy. Here, doggy. Where is that dreaded animal? Here, Toto.
I asked you to get off of my land, Miss Gulch.
I did, but the dog got away.
He can't endure your company much.
Where the little girl is, that's where I'll find him. Kindly bring her out here now.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy!
Dorothy!
Oh, she ain't in the house. Henry, the fresh batch of cookies is missing, and my picture's on the mantle. It's gone, too. Sounds like you've got a runaway on your hands. If she's on the road, I'll find her there. Then I'll get the dog back for good.
Well, if you're so anxious to have it, maybe you should have looked after it better.
Don't blame me. The catch on the basket is faulty. That's the last time I've had anything from a charity bazaar.
It were best it be done, equally, on both sides. Well, 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 house guest, huh? And who might you be? No, no, now, don't tell me. You're traveling in disguise. No, that's not right. You're going on a visit. No, I'm wrong. You're running away.
Well, how did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses. He knows. Now, why are you running away?
Well...
No, don't tell me. They don't understand you at home. They don't appreciate you. You want to see other lands, big cities, big oceans, and big mountains.
Oh, why, it's just like you can read what's inside of me.
It's my trait, my calling. See what's on the side of my trunk?
Asked to go with him yet.
He's perfectly welcome. One dog to another, eh? Now, where were we?
Oh, please, Professor, why can't we go with you to see all the crown heads of Europe?
Do you know any? Oh, you mean the thing. Yes, well, I never do anything without consulting my crystal first. Here, just sit down right here. Yes, that's it. Just sit right there and make yourself comfortable while I conjure out of air, thin air, this very genuine, magic, authentic crystal used by the priests of Isis and Osiris in the days of Egypt, in which Cleopatra first saw the rise of Mark Antony and Julius Caesar and so on and so on. Now, hold out your hand so we can look into the future. Now, you better close your eyes, my child, to be better in tune with the infinite. We can't do these things without reaching out into the infinite. Yes, that's all right. Now you can open them. We will gaze into the crystal together. Oh, what's this I see? A house with a picket fence.
That's our farm.
Yes, there's a woman. She's wearing a polka dot dress. Her face is Carol.
Oh, that's Auntie Em.
Yes, her name is Emily.
Oh, that's right. What is she doing?
Well, I can't quite see. Why, she's crying.
Oh.
Someone has hurt her. Someone has just about broken her heart.
Well, why would anybody do that?
I don't know, but it's someone she loves very much. Someone she's been very kind to. Someone she's taking care of in sickness.
Oh, well, I had the measles once, when she stayed right by me every minute.
Uh-huh.
Oh, but she didn't care about me now, and I didn't care about her.
That's not what the crystal says.
Well, they were gonna kill Dodo, and she did nothing to stop them.
I don't see any of that in the crystal. All I see is a woman who does the best she can and misses you something terrible.
Oh, well, what is she doing now?
Well, she's grabbing onto her heart. She's jumping down on the bed.
Oh, you don't think she could really be sick, do you? We've got to get home to her right away. Come on, Toto.
But what's this? I thought you were coming along with me.
Oh, no, I have to get home to her right away, Professor. Oh, goodbye. Thanks for everything.
Goodbye. Better get everything under cover. There's a storm blowing, a whopper.
Hope that kid gets home all right.
Toto's my dog.
I'm a little muddled. The munchkins hold me because someone has dropped me off. But we can push
east. And there's the house, and here you are. And those legs, they're all that's left of the Wicked Witch. And so, what the Munchkins want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Oh, but I've already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Oh, witches are old and ugly. What was that?
Those are the Munchkins. They're laughing because I'm a witch. I'm Glinda, the Witch of the North.
Who you are? Oh, I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
But witch, if you please, what are Munchkins?
They're the little people that live in this land. This is Munchkin Land, and you, my dear, are the national heroine. It's all right, you may all come out and thank her now.
For all the money.
the west, and she's much worse.
Where's my sister?
Yonder she lies.
Where?
There.
All right. Who's the smart aleck that turned her into a house? Was it you, Glinda?
Not the house. Under the house.
Under the house?
Oh, I'm so sorry. It's my fault my house dropped on her.
You dropped your house on my sister? How can anyone be so unbelievably clumsy?
Look closer. You recognized her then?
Of course I recognized her. Who else would wear ruby slippers with those socks? The ruby slippers? My dear, you have done me a service. I shall don the ruby slippers, which will make my powers greater than ever. The ruby slippers! They're gone. What have you done with them, Glinda?
See for yourself. Step forward, Dorothy.
You give me back those slippers, or
there they are, and there they'll stay.
Give them back to me! I'm the only one that knows how to use them. They're of no use to you. Give them back!
Keep tight inside them. The magic is very powerful, but she wouldn't want them so badly.
You stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well.
Oh, fiddle faddle. You have no power while I'm here. Now be gone before someone drops a house on you, too.
You fine lady. She's right. I can't attend to you here and now as I'd like. But after a suitable period of mourning, I will have my slippers and my revenge too. So, best try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you eventually, my pretty, and your little dog too.
It's all right. She's gone. You can get up now. It's all right. What a smell of sulfur. I'm afraid you've made a rather bad enemy of the Wicked Witch of the West. The sooner you get out of Oz altogether, the safer you'll sleep, my dear.
Oh, I'd give anything to get out of Oz altogether. My aunt yet was missing me, and she may even be sick. But which is the way back to Kansas? I can't go the way I came.
Oh, that is true. The only one that might know is the great and powerful Wizard of Oz himself.
The Wizard of Oz? Is he good or is he wicked?
Well, he's very good, but very mysterious. He lives in the Emerald City. That's a very far way from here. Have you brought your broomstick with you?
No, I'm afraid I didn't.
Very well. You have to walk then. The Munchkins will see you safely to the border of Munchkin Land. And remember, never let those ruby slippers off your feet for even a moment, or you may be at the mercy of the Wicked Witch of the West.
But how do I start for the Emerald City?
It's always best to start at the beginning, and all you have to do is follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Well, but what happens
to the Yellow Brick Road?
So quickly here, follow the Yellow Brick Road. Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Follow the Yellow Brick Road.
Let's go.
It's pleasant down that way, too.
Oh, that's funny. But wasn't he just pointing the other way? Oh.
Of course, people do go both ways.
Oh, well, you did say something, didn't you? Oh, are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
I don't have a brain, only straw. I don't have a mind to make up.
Oh, well, then how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
I don't know. Some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Yes, you're right, yes. Well, can't you get down?
Down? No, you see how that pole stuck up my...
Oh! Can I help you?
Of course, I'm not too bright about doing things, but maybe you just bend the nail down the back. Maybe I'll just slip off.
Oh, I'll certainly try. Oh my, it's an awful stiff nail.
Oh, there goes some more of me again.
Oh, does it hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again.
Oh, here, let me help you up.
Oh, my goodness, free! Did I scare you?
Oh, no, of course not. I just thought you hurt yourself.
Did I even scare you?
Oh, no.
I didn't think so. You see, I can't even scare a crow. It could run miles around just to eat my field and laugh in my face. Well, I'm a failure, because I haven't got a brain.
Well, what would you do if you did have a brain?
Do? Wow. I would while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts are busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts you'd be thinking, you could be
an elegant. If I only had a brain. Oh, and then I'd sit and think some more. Well, I would not be just a nothing. My head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry. Life would be a dingy-dairy if I only had a brain. The reason for things I can't explain. Well, then perhaps I deserve you and be even worthier of you. But if I only had a brain. You're gonna see a wizard?
Yes.
Do you think if I went with you, this wizard would give me some brain?
Oh, well, I couldn't say, but you couldn't be any worse off than you are now.
Well, that's true.
Oh, but you'd better not. Oh, I've got a witch after me, and she might get us into some trouble.
Oh, a witch? Oh, I'm afraid of a witch. I'm afraid of anything. Except a lucky match.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Well, I'll face a whole box of them just for a chance you need to get some brains. Now, listen, I won't be in any trouble, because I don't want you to think. And I will try to manage things, because I can't think. Won't you take me with you?
Of course I will.
Oh, yippee! I'm going to give myself a brain!
Oh, goodness! Oh, you're not starting out very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz.
Come on.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard, who is if ever a wizard there was. If ever, ever a wizard there was, the wizard of Oz is one because
hungry.
Oh, all living things need to eat.
Well, I don't need to eat. You mean I'm not alive?
Oh, no, Scarecrow, you're the liveliest friend I ever had.
Oh, why, thank you. Just for that, you can be as much as my hair as you like.
Oh, I couldn't do that.
Oh, you don't have to worry about me. As long as I keep my legs well stuffed, I can get to the Emerald City no matter what shape I'm in on top.
Oh, it's a very kind offer, Scarecrow, but I'm okay.
Oh, perhaps it's just as well. There's one more field mouse in here. She won't like to be disturbed.
Oh, look, Scarecrow, apples.
Apples? What's apples?
In the trees.
Oh, you mean all those little red birds hanging upside down by 1 foot?
Oh, those aren't birds. They're something you eat. They're delicious.
Ouch!
What do you think you're doing?
Oh, it's just that we were walking a long ways and I was hungry and... Did you say something?
She was hungry.
Oh, she was hungry. How would you like to have someone come along and pick something off of you?
I'm sorry, I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
No, come on, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Yep.
Are you suggesting my apples aren't what they ought to be?
Oh, no, she said she doesn't like little green worms.
Worms? Did you just say we had worms?
That's what it sounded like to me.
Oh, she got to get apples. Sure, you got worms, caterpillars, probably a whole bunch of wood lice.
God damn it!
Let's give it to them, girls!
Oh, we like them just fine.
I
said
the twigs.
Me too. It makes sense of us all.
I think it's time we bow out.
Why, it's a man! What's a man made out of tin?
Oh, what?
Look!
Oh,
he's saying something.
Again! Did take up my other leg instead. So, I got myself a new leg, and back I went to work.
Oh, you sure were persistent.
This time, I chopped off both my arms.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, I see you can chop off one. How'd you chop off the other?
I told you, the axe is enchanted.
Oh, see, Dorothy, quite a worry. Not going to figure that out myself.
I sometimes wish I hadn't had a new set of arms. Because the last time I chopped was the worst of them all.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
Oh, I split myself right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
So, the tinsmith gave me a new headed body, but on the way home I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and I rusted solid.
Oh, it just wasn't your day, was it?
Well, you're ready now.
Oh, my neck. Oh, please oil me. Perfect. Just bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead, bang on it.
Oh, beautiful! One knuckle.
It's empty. The tinsmith meant to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart. And with no heart, I could never love my luncheon maiden again.
Oh, please don't cry, tin man. You'll rust again.
I used to carve her name in every tree.
You can say that again.
When a man's an empty kettle, he should be not his rebel, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental, recording a loving art. I'd happy pets with the sparrows and the boy that shoots the arrows. If I only had a heart. Picture me a balcony. A marble voice sings low.
Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
To hear a beat.
How sweet.
Just to register emotion. Jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I would stay young and chipper in that locket with a zipper if I only had a heart.
about you? Right about things, but I think it gets a lot lighter before it gets a lot darker.
Probably.
Oh,
you don't suppose we meet new wild animals, do you?
Animals? But
it's true! But mostly lions and tigers and bears. And bears.
Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Put 'em up. Which one of you boys, Stella? I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with a paw behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, sneaking up on me, pulling an axe on me.
Are you being here? Go away and leave us alone.
Oh, I'm scared, afraid, Hey. How long do you stay fresh in that can? Come on! Get up and fight, you shivering junkyard! Put your hands up, you lopsided rat!
Oh, my life's getting personal,
why? Get up and teach him a lesson!
Oh, what do I really teach them?
I hardly know him!
Well, I'll teach you anyway, Pee-wee.
Oh, shame on you!
What did you do that for? I didn't bite him.
No, but you tried to. Oh, it is bad enough going around beating a strong man. Oh, but a poor little dog.
What did you do that to go and hit me, did you? Is my nose bleeding?
No, of course not. Oh my goodness, what a fuss you're making. That's when you go around pushing out things bigger than you are. Oh, you're nothing but a great big coward, aren't you?
Oh, you're right. I am a coward. I haven't got the courage at all. Oh, I even scare myself. Oh, here, look at the circles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Oh,
that doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
Why don't you come to see the wizard with us? Oh, we're going to go get him a harp
and come and pray.
Oh, I'm sure he can give you some courage.
Wouldn't you feel degraded to be sitting in the company of a cowardly lion? I know I would.
Oh, of course not.
Oh, gee, that's awfully nice of you. You see, my life has been simply unbearable. Even my family's disowned me. When I was just a little boy, my father hit me off the side of a high mountain, waved his paws around and said, "One day, son, all this will be yours." I was
terrified.
I'm scared of heights.
Well, it's all right now. The wizard will fix everything.
Well, at least we'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me.
Right beside me, you've been missing when you're born to be a sissy.
Without the winning boy.
For I could change my habits nevermore, be scared of rabbits if I only had the noise. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a failure to destroy. Or I could show my traps be a lion, not a moment since I only have the noise.
How are you, the anchor shine, a king down to the core?
I could roar the way I never roared before,
and then I'd
roll some more. sauce, who's came about the force,
a king that ever slave. Why, with my regal beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the door. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard, who will serve?
Then I'm sure to get a brain,
a heart,
a home,
the knife.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. And here he is, a wizard, a wizard, a wizard, a wizard, a wizard. In fact, a wizard, a wizard, a wizard, a wizard.
Dorothy, you're awake!
Look, what magic has done its work.
Bust my buttons. You should have said that in the first place. That's a horse of a different color. he got a horse? Why is he on the other side like dog?
Oh, here he goes!
Might be on this side.
Welcome to the Emerald City.
Thank you.
Have you come far?
There's the longest way.
Believe me, every step is worth it. Do you have any idea just how wonderful this place really is?
That's how we got the day away.
be okay. The great thoughtful Oz had matters well in hand, I hope. And so, you can all go home. Go on, get out of here. Everybody go home. And I said go home. Can't you hear me?
Well, look who we're trying to do, sir. Sir, we have to see the wizard right away. All four of us.
Orders are nobody can see the great Oz. Not nobody, not no how.
But we've
come
such a long way.
And I got a just for your picture.
Not nobody, not know how.
Well, you gotta make him see, Dorothy.
Dorothy? Did you say Dorothy? The witch's Dorothy?
In person.
Well, that makes a difference. All of you wait here. I'll announce you immediately.
Faintly hear my heart beating.
Who can we hold until we suffer?
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king. If I were king of the forest, not queen, not duke, not prince, my regal robes of the forest would be satin, not cotton, not chintz. I'd command each thing, be it fish or fowl,
with a ruff and a ruff
and a royal
ruff.
As I click my heel, on the trees would kneel, and the mountains bow, and the walls come. And the sparrow would take wing. Five were killed.
Each a right would show respect to me.
The chipmunks genuflect to me. Though my tail would lash, I would show compassion for every other. Five were just killed.
Running away and hurting her feelings. She made me sick.
Please don't cry anymore. I'll get you to see the wizard somehow.
Thank you.
It's all right. I knew it in myself once. Right this way, follow me.
Wait a minute, fellas. I was just thinking. I really don't want to see this wizard that much anyway. I better just wait to get out of here.
What's the matter? The wizard's gonna give you some courage.
I've been too scared to ask him for it.
It's alright, Ryan. We're scared together.
Water! Somebody pull my dam!
Oh, you did that yourself!
I'm such a butterball.
This way! Step right up! The green powerful Oz awaits you!
Oh, tell me when it's over!
Thank you.
crazy scheme. I never should have let you see the wizard.
Well, but I'm glad you did. How else can I get back to Kansas?
You won't worry about us.
Oh. We're not going after this witch empty handed.
Oh, that's right.
Well, where's her castle?
No one knows for sure.
But you mean no one's ever been there?
Oh, plenty of folk have been there, but no one's ever come back.
Well, there's no yellow brick road to follow anymore.
There's no road at all to the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? What's Winkies?
Once, they are very like us. The Wicked Witch made them her slaves. I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
Oh, so do I.
Keep heading west where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
Don't worry, Dorothy. When the witch knows you're in the land of the Winkies, she'll find you. Good luck.
Sometimes it's a good thing not to have a brain. I don't have the witch to be scared.
And I don't have the brain to fail.
And I have been said goodbye to the wizard.
How could you get away from Dorothy now?
Well, I can stay here. That's one way of doing it.
You're even more of a coward than I thought.
Well, basically, you were saying, you're made of straw, you're made of tin, but I'm only weak flesh.
Very weak. Verging on flabby.
It's all right, Lion. You can sit here if you'd like.
Oh, I'd like. Oh, how I'd like. But if you really need me, I'll tag along, I guess.
Laugh more like
you. Stop, fellow.
Ready to go, Dorothy?
Best come forward.
Oh, decisions, decisions.
Oh, come on,
Lion. Oh, all right, I'm coming. Scarecrow's not the only one that needs a new brain. Wait up!
She's prissy, she's clueless, and I want her shoeless. I'll
show her how fiendishly mean I can be. I want those shoes to establish just who's number one from the east to the west. Then I'll be complete with a world at my feet, and red always suited me best. I know I hold sway over all I survey, but I now need a much bigger deal. The shoes are the key to the making of me, so find her and bring her to me. When I get that footwear from her, and it put where it could have been, should have been, right from the start, my power will grow. It will blossom and flow through the world, through the years, and straight to my heart. We all like to dance, so now here's your chance. You'll dance till your very last gasp. Gyrate, pirouette, you'll swelter and sweat, and stumble right into my grasp. You'll find you can't stop till you dance, till you drop, and stumble right into my grasp.
Haunted forest. Well, actually, it's a haunted forest. I'd turn back if I were you.
That could mean anything.
Why didn't you tell us sooner?
Oh, well, I was too afraid. Not as brave as I look, you know.
Oh, you're telling me.
Oh. Oh, come on. To the witch's castle.
Rich gods and new gods, I'll tear them apart. Oh, I may not come out alive, but I'll go down fighting. Now, there's only one thing I want you two fellas to do.
What's that?
Talk me out of it.
I hope
revolting with an apple in his mouth. Here, take them.
Who are you going with? Why can't he stay with me?
Because the raging, roaring river is some way off. Is he a water breed?
No, I don't think so.
Well, he soon will be, because that's where I'm throwing him if you don't cough up those slippers.
Oh, please, you can have them. I don't want them. Just give me back Toto.
Oh, that's a good little girl. I knew you'd see reason.
Oh, come on, run away from as far as you can.
That's it, you called!
Oh, we got away. We got away from you.
That's more than you're up to. Fool that I am. I knew the slippers would never come off as long as you're alive. See this? That's how long you're left to live. And it's not very long, dear. Just long enough for me to come up with an evil plan to kill you. There is one route of escape. It's a long way down. So, if you do choose that route, be a dear and leave the slippers on the windowsill so I don't have to drag them off your corpse.
Oh, how can anyone be so nasty, mean, and cruel?
Oh, lots and lots of practice.
Oh, Auntie Em, I'm frightened. Oh, I'm so frightened, Auntie Em.
Dorothy?
Oh.
Dorothy?
Auntie Em?
Dorothy?
Oh, Auntie Em, is that you?
Dorothy, dear, oh. I'm trying to find you.
Oh, I'm in Oz, Auntie Em, and I'm locked Dorothy. In the witch's castle.
Dorothy?
Oh, I'm trying to get back to you, Auntie Em, but I can't. Oh, Auntie Em, please don't leave me. Stay here.
Dorothy?
Dropping him like this.
Yes, I'm fine, but the witch has locked me in.
Save that light, break the door open.
Oh, hurry, please, hurry. The timer's almost Oh, I knew you'd come, Toto.
We're hurrying you up with time.
Well, we can't take her out the way we came.
Well, what about the window?
Oh, the cliff is sheer.
Oh, don't worry. You can all hang out right there, and I'll hang out with my claws.
Oh, you're wonderful, all of you.
Oh, I just hope my courage holds out.
Please just hope your tail holds out.
The window!
Wizard of Oz.
You are? Why, I don't believe you.
No, I'm afraid it's true. There's no other wizard except me.
You humbug!
Yeah.
Yes, that's exactly so. I'm a humbug.
Oh, you're a very bad man.
Oh, no, my dear. I'm a very good man. I'm just a very bad wizard.
Oh, what about the heart you brought his teeth at?
Well,
and Scarecrow's brain.
Why, anybody can have a brain. That's a very mediocre commodity. Back where I come from, we have universities where men go to become great thinkers. And when they come out, they think deep thoughts. And they've got no more brains than you've got. But they have one thing you haven't got. A diploma. Therefore, by the authority vested in me by the Universitatis Committeum Eclairis Unum, I hereby confer upon you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Yeah, that's Doctor of Thinkology.
The sum of the square roots of any two sides when the sides of the triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side.
Oh, it's only right, I've got brains!
How can I ever thank you?
Well, you can't. As for you, my fine friend, you're under the unfortunate delusion that simply because you run away from danger means you have no courage. You're confusing courage with wisdom. Back where I come from, we have heroes who once a year take their fortitude out of the mothballs and parade it down the main street. And they've got no more courage than you've got, but they have one thing you haven't got. A medal. Therefore, for meritorious conduct, extraordinary valor, and conspicuous bravery against wicked witches, I award you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Oh, shucks! I'm speechless!
And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a harp. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They're called good deed doers. And they do nothing all day but good deeds. And they've got no more heart than you've got, but they have one thing you haven't got. A testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness at this time, I take pleasure in presenting you with a small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, hearts are not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, listen to my heart. It ticks!
Oh,
awarded for courage.
Ain't it the truth?
It's all so wonderful.
What about Dorothy?
Yes, what about Dorothy?
Yes.
Yeah, the Dorothy Nuts.
Oh, what? I don't think there's anything in there for me.
Well, you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way for me to get Dorothy to Kansas is for me to take her myself.
Oh, could you? Would you? Oh, but are you a clever enough wizard to manage it?
Child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself, premier balloonist par excellence for the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company, until one day, while performing feats at a stratospheric skill never before attempted by civilized man, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
It did?
Frightened, Maria.
Frightened? You're talking to the man who laughed in the face of death, sneered at doom, and chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. Then suddenly, the wind changed, and the balloon floated down into the heart of this noble city, where I was instantly acclaimed, the first wizard deluxe.
Deluxe, on the gate to the French, all to it!
Well, few luxuries went with the job, but I took it anyway, retaining the balloon in the advent of a quick getaway. And in that conveyance, my dear Dorothy, the balloon is ready for us, and we return to the land of E. Claribus Unum.
Thank you.
embark upon a hazardous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere to converse, confer, and otherwise hobnob with my brother wizards. And in that time, if any, that I shall return, the Scarecrow, by virtue of his highly superior brains, shall lead in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, for virtue of his magnificent heart, and Lion, by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. And now, I think it's time to cast off. Climb aboard, Dorothy. Climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy. Well, the wind's in your favor.
Where's Toto? I can't go without him. Toto, where are you?
Don't worry.
Don't let go of that rope! This is highly irregular procedure.
Completely
unprecedented.
Oh, please don't go, Professor.
I'm sorry, too late, my dear.
Oh, you have to come back, Professor, please.
I can't. I don't know how this thing works.
Oh, help me.
Goodbye, folks.
Here's your dog.
Toto, I was so happy we were almost home. Well, now I'll never get there.
Well, then stay with us, Dorothy.
No, I need to leave.
Well, you know I'd love to, but there's a place and people I love far more. Oh, and now it seems further away than the furthest street.
Well, Dorothy, there's someone who can help you.
Can you help me? Will you help me?
Not any longer. You've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have. You think you're lost, but that's not true. You simply live a dream or two. You traveled all this way to find. You never left your home behind. Home is a place in your heart. Every journey leads you back to where you start. Close your eyes, it's very easy.
Thank you.
have to do is close your eyes, tap your heels together 3 times, and think over and over, there's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Get out all night in the storm.
We'd best get back in time and notify the sheriff.
Wait, there she is!
Dorothy!
Oh, she's over here!
Dorothy?
She's got a lump on her head the size of an ostrich egg, but the skin ain't broken.
Hello? Oz?
Oz? My first name's Chester, but you can call me whatever you'd like.
Uncle Henry!
Is she all right?
There was a moment there where I thought she'd left us.
Oh, but I did leave you, Uncle Henry. Oh, that's just the trouble. I tried to get back for days and days.
Sounds like a bad dream.
Oh, it wasn't a dream.
Sure, it wasn't.
Well, you remember me, don't you? Your old pal Zeke?
Lion.
No, I ain't. Well, this here's Hawk. Well, you couldn't forget my face, could you?
Oh, of course not. Oh, but where's Tin Man?
Tin Man?
Who the heck is Tin Man?
I brought the blanket you asked for. How is she?
She'll be fine.
Here you are. Wait, where's your oil can?
Oil can?
Dorothy. Oh, ATM.
Oh, Dorothy, dear, you're safe and well.
She's all right, Adam. She's got a bump on her head.
Sounds like she had a bad dream.
Oh, but it wasn't a dream. Oh, it was a truly alive place. And, oh, I remember that all of it wasn't very good. But when most of it was wonderful. And you all were there. You kept resting. Oh, and you kept filling your own tail. Oh, and you were such a humbug.
Hey now, let's not get personal.
Doesn't anyone believe me?
Oh, of course we believe you, dear. Now let's just get you into bed.
Where's the house? Come back. It landed on the way you went, you know.
Well, the storm flew right by.
And it wasn't a house that fell in the scholars and telegraph.
You won't be hearing from that old Billy till her leg gets out of flask.
The door is safe. You hear that door? Well, you're safe. And we're home. Home. Oh, and we're never gonna leave forever again. Oh, and I love you all so much. And oh, KTM, there really is no place like home.